you can go in and fix your S's manually. In Cubase, if the S is loud enough, you can use the range selection tool, hold Command or Control Shift, and it'll detect it, and then you can pull it down. If that doesn't work, you can just select and pull it down. Or you can use the draw tool. The advantage of catching it on clip level is that now it's just as if you recorded the S's quieter, because clip gain happens before it goes into the effects chain. That being said, you can de-ess in the effects chain. In the Cubase stock de-esser, you can see how a de-esser works. So it's a compressor that only looks at one frequency band, the one where your S's are. And depending on the vocal, you can find the right frequencies. And when those get too loud, the compressor kicks in. You can also make your own de-esser if you have an EQ plugin that lets you do dynamic EQing. So let's say my S's are here, so I want to pull this down. But actually, I only want to pull it down when there's a loud S. So I want this part of the EQ to act like a compressor. And if I click here, well, what do you know? We have compression parameters to control the dynamics of this one frequency band. And now it only pulls down when this frequency band is too loud. Some other issues you can have with S's. Sometimes when you have pitch correction on a vocal, it also pitches your S's. And then they sound really weird and robotic. Some pitch correction tools handle that very well. And in some tools, like Very Audio in Cubase, you can go in and make sure the S's are not being tuned. Something else you might run into when you're doing harmonies or doubles, any kind of vocal stack, maybe the S's of those background vocals stand out a little too much. Maybe because of timing, maybe because of the way they're panned, maybe because you don't feel like surgically de-essing them like you would with a lead vocal. In most cases, the S's of the lead vocal are enough, and you can just get rid of the S's of the background vocals. You won't even notice they're gone, and the stacks sound tighter.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video, subscribe, and have fun making music.